This is a Mobbs Miller last. It's a 3689. It's imprinted on my hand somewhere, because when I cut for this. So there it is, it's sitting in, that's how I want it to sit. This is a 3B Mobbs Miller. It's about the same as a 4.5 shoe. This particular one has a little patch on the inside, because the last time I used it, I wanted to make the toe on the inside a bit fuller. Generally, these lasts are a little bit narrower than people need today. We're heavier bone than we were in the 20s. So, and this last, again, it works quite well as a shoe last. A lot of the clog lasts people use are boot lasts. Now, a boot is designed to hold round here, and it's deeper here. So when you make a clog to fit a person and use a boot last, as they nearly always do, people say, oh, you've got to wear several pairs of socks. It's because the last is too deep. And it's not designed for a shoe. A shoe fits from there to there. That's how it fits. A boot fits around there. So the last isn't the same. So anyway, we've got last. This is the hollower. Now this, again, is in Wales, sometimes they're made in two pieces. Now on the stock knife, which you saw me use, it's very fine. Actually, you want it as fine as you can get it. You want quite a steep edge on the back. It's, I don't know, maybe 30 degrees, 25, 30. Well, that other one's more like 15. If you don't have that, it doesn't, if you don't have it, it doesn't sit on the back bevel. So when you go down here, it rocks and you get a series of ripples. That's cutting a nice straight line. Do you see? I'm not getting any ripples, it's just going straight down. So I've got that. Now you can do the chamfer on the edge first or second. I've just chosen to do it with this first. I'll show you what the chamfer is in a minute. So we cut down here. Okay. Now the lasts come bowed. That's better. It's sitting, beginning to sit in. They come bowed across here. Now the main weight of the foot is on this joint, just here. So I actually drop my soles. I don't copy this. I drop this here to make the lowest part of the sole just there, or same level as that. Certainly not any higher, because you, if somebody's got a very pronounced joint, they've done a lot of barefoot walking, then this is really uncomfortable. So we just we'll knock into here. And I like this curve here to be a straight line. A lot of the machine ones aren't, and it's just for ease of machining. So this is quite a curve here, which if you get it right can be a support for the arch, but it's more, I tend to do it more just for strength, so they're less likely to break. And then, yeah, that's not too bad. Now we've got a problem, because we're going one way and then we're coming back this way again. So what do you do with the join, and what do I do about this? I use what's called in Wales a tucker cam. So that's a tucker cam, and this is what you do with it. It's very much like a spoon knife. You just clean out. This I just tend to use just to clean up. So we'll leave it at that for now, for that knife. The three knives, well, you've seen two work so far in this. And then we'll go back to doing the edge. We'll see it again, okay? So I'll just draw this line back on. It changes a bit, because when you put it into a curve, it becomes narrow again.
So you put the pattern on flat. You put the pattern on after you've done the curve. It's not the same shape.
So I've done the hollowing for the foot. It's roughly about right. Ledge is about right. Tend to leave it a little bit wide. If I really foul up, then I can add a little piece of leather in between the upper and the sole to make it a bit wider if I need to. It doesn't show in the final product and doesn't make any difference how long it lasts. So I sometimes do that. So I don't always take the bevel right down tight. But you can cut the bevel with this. But I tend to cut it with a stock knife. I tend to prefer to do it with this. So basically, you're cutting in and you're feeling the knife. If it starts to bind, you know it's splitting. So I can feel it there. It's not cutting, it's splitting. So you feel it. And it doesn't, it depends on the wood you're working. You're going in, so it shouldn't split. But you're going up, so you're going away from the grain, so it could split. So you're never quite sure there whether you're going to be able to run right through or you're going to have to come back. So anyway, just right round here. And then we chamfer this. And that's dangerously close. That's the reason why, because we've got a little knot in there. So it wanted to take the grain off in a different direction. So it just wanted to split on me. I think I got away with it. Let me just clean around here. And all the time, I'm working the sole as well. I'll just take a little bit off there. That's where the bark was. But just take a bit off there. You don't have to be this anal about it, but it helps. So I've got this. I'll look at that and go, well, okay, take a little bit off there. Completely disagree with what I just said. That's okay. So normally you'd do this in a pair. I was taught to do one and then the other, but that's complete rubbish. You do it in a pair, then you don't have to go back and alter one to fit to the other. And we look at these curves and go, okay, that's okay. That's pretty good. So the next thing is the gripper bit. This is the V blade or gripper bit. If you look, it's really quite a weird profile on the blade. It's not 90 degrees, but you want it to cut 90 degrees. So don't ask me the mathematical formula because I can't work it out. But basically, it's narrower, but it's angled. Now, you can cut in a straight line a 90 degree bend. It's dead easy to do. When you go around a corner, one of two things happens. Either the wood breaks or the blade does. Quite often it's the blade, which is quite surprising. And the reason is because everything is engaging at the same time. So you can't turn corners with it. With this, when you cut it, you see, just the center section engages first, and then as you go in fuller, the other bits, this means that you can actually go around corners with it. This knife broke. I managed to snap this once. I think there was a fault in it. It wasn't brute force and ignorance. And I got it reprofiled by Matt Sears, who was a toolmaker down in Pembrokeshire at the time. He's disappeared off the face of the earth. I tried to find him, but he's gone. Went to America. I don't know what he's doing now. I just said to him, please just copy the thing, don't even think about it, don't even think about reprofiling it, just take it, make it an inch shorter,
get rid of the fault and get it back to me, which is what he did. Did a really nice job on it. But that was 14, 15 years ago. So you're going round the corner. And then that's where that knot is. I've got to watch that. Just be careful when I go through it. Now, when Thomas James did this, he didn't do anything more. So he didn't come back and clean this out. He just did it with his knife. And that was that. You can actually see it on his clogs, that they wouldn't be, there'd be a slight roughness right here at the point where they met. You're going one with the other. Didn't matter a damn. Then we're just cutting around. You see I'm moving my hand. This is the safest knife to use. It's pretty impossible to cut yourself with it. It's very possible to cut yourself with the other ones, quite badly in fact. But it's the trickiest because I'm doing most of the work with my left hand. And I didn't realise I was until I came to teach Garrett. And he wondered why he couldn't do it. And I wondered why he couldn't do it. Till we found out what I was doing. And then it all became crystal clear. So we got that, we got this. Got a slight problem here because we're going one way and then we're going the other. So we just try and clean this. Made it a little bit deeper. I don't like it, it's a bit shallow there. That's
actually perfectly okay to finish. You can play around with it, you can do quite a lot with it, you can clean out this, you know, keep fiddling around with it, and you have to these days because people demand a really good finish. In terms of the product, it probably doesn't make a slightest bit of difference. So that's your sole,